It's all about planting tomatoes today, and I'll show you how to get the biggest harvest you've ever had.
And how whole grain corn meal can greatly enhance the productivity of your tomato plants. All that coming up today on the Wisconsin Vegetable Gardener. Wisconsin Vegetable Gardener is sponsored in part by,
for all your non-GMO, organic, and heirloom vegetable, flowers, and herb seeds, visit dollarseed.com.
Sioux Growing Supply,
located in Wausau, Wisconsin, focusing on certified leaf compost, an excellent amendment for poor soil, retains moisture and adds nutrients, which equals less watering. Available in Labor Saver pre-filled trays and pots, bag and bulk. Visit SueCompost.com. Organic fertilizer for the health-conscious organic home gardener. Family owned and operated. Visit WGardens.com.
Don't poison your soil with municipal water. Attach a body, mind, and soil hose filter. Free shipping exclusively through the WisconsinVegetableGardener.com. Just click on the body, mind, and soil icon.
Authentic Haven brand soil conditioner for the home gardener. Easy to brew. Visit ManureTea.com. No measuring, no thinking. Stamp it, plant it, stop plotting, start planting. GardenStamp.com.
Welcome to the Wisconsin Vegetable Gardener. I'm Joy Baird. Well, it's time to plant our tomatoes, and we're very excited for that. We're doing it in a couple of different techniques of planting them. We've got about 23 varieties of tomatoes we're planting in four different locations, four different gardens. If you want to know the varieties we're planting, you can go to our website. It's the same name as our show, thewisconsinvegetablegardener.com, and you can click on the tab at the top that's about tomatoes, and it'll list all of those for you and give you an identification whether they're determinate, indeterminate, and approximate days to maturity. So if you're growing the same thing we are, you can kind of have an idea of what and when to expect the harvest. So we've got a couple of different methods of support. We've got the traditional cage here. They're not that structurally sound, but they are effective, and we most likely will have to stake many of these. But if this is all you have, that's great. You want to get the tomatoes up off the ground. We've also constructed a couple of different cages, as you see here. Now this is about almost 6 foot tall here. We'll have two bamboo stakes holding it up, approximately 18 inches in diameter, and then we will go ahead and put two tomatoes in each one of these. It'll be very tight, but it'll be very worthy to have two tomatoes in one of these larger cages, and then one tomato everywhere else. And then on the high end, we've got the Florida weave going on, and we'll show you how to go about finishing that Florida weave that we started several weeks ago on a tips, tricks, and techniques segment on the program. So let's get started here by planting some tomatoes. All right, so we've pre-dug our holes here, and I've done it with a large shovel, and then as I need to backfill to get the proper depth, I can certainly do that. This is where one of the big cages is going to go, like I have to the neighbor here. I'm going to take first any discoloring of the leaves. I'm just going to ahead and pinch off first of all, get rid of those. This one's got a little discoloring there. I'm going to get rid of that. Now, if you are going to plant tomatoes or purchase tomato starts, and you see them with buds on them, don't buy them. Or if you've got them that are budding out that you've got in your grow room, pinch the buds off. You're not going to help yourself by planting a tomato that has buds on it already. You're just going to stress the tomato out even more. Go ahead and pinch them off, plant them, allow them to get a good root development, and then let them naturally progress in height and then put on flowers when the plant sees fit. So we want to take the tomatoes out. They are slightly root bound, not severely. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to unravel and tease the bottom. Teasing means just simply loosening the roots up. Now this is fairly moist because we wanted to keep these as hydrated as possible. And by loosening, that's enough to where the plant realizes that I'm not in a confined environment anymore. I can explore with my roots here. We'll do the same on this one here. This one you can see is raveled a little tighter. So I'm just going to gently unravel that and loosen that up. You don't have to worry about too much of the top roots. They'll kind of disperse around themselves. So now that we've got both of those, since this is a double hole, or we're going to put two in with our giant cages, that's clearly too deep. Tomatoes are a part of the nightshade family, which means that you can bury them as deep as you can, but you want some top growth exposed so it can get the photosynthesis. So I'm just going to backfill in just a little bit here. That would be about right. Ground level is somewhere in that area. So then you just want to pinch the bottom leaves off. You do want to leave a little bit on the canopy here, because if you just went completely bald this plant off, it's going to put in a tremendous shock because it can't absorb any sunlight. So we're going to plant that. I'm going to take that leaf off, just get rid of it. That leaf looks detrimental, but all the tiny little fibers are going to, when exposed to moisture or soil, are going to develop roots. All right, so we're going to put them in the ground here. About ground level there is where that's going to be. I'm going to pinch that off. It really is less stress on the plant because it's not trying to support life on all the leaves there. Now, with it being a double hole, we're just going to space them relatively, as far apart as we can. Now, two things we want to do here. One, we want to get some rock phosphate. Rock phosphate, we put it directly, one handful under each plant. What rock phosphate allows the plant to do is it grows through the rock phosphate, and by putting the rock phosphate, just one handful, put the plant right on top of it, it allows the plant to double in production. It's just a wonderful miracle of nature on that. So since we got two plants, two rock phosphate. We're also going to add some blood meal. This is optional, not required. It is a nitrogen. It's a 1200. So we're just going to take one, the recommended measurement for the hole we have here. This will be active in about 6 to 8 weeks. We want a lot of nitrogen because these plants are going to get very, very large. And we want a nice nitrogen. So in about 6 to 8 weeks, these plants will be, getting up there. And that'll help. Not mandatory, but it will greatly enhance the health and well-being of the tomato plant. Now we just backfill. And you want to take and you want to get soil up around that stem, because that's where those roots, that hair follicles, are going to develop roots. Now we've prepped the soil several months ago by adding a pile of certified leaf compost in each place where we're going to plant tomatoes, and then putting a handful of Epsom salt on top of that pile to allow the plant to be able to more successfully pick up the calcium to prevent blossom and root rot. Now, if you have not done that yet, you can take a handful of Epsom salt and put around at the time of planting, a little bit in the hole and a little bit around the top of the tomato plant. And as the tomato plant grows and before it bears fruit, it will dissolve and allow the plant to pick up that Epsom salt, which in turn helps the plant pick up the calcium that's in the soil. So now that that's done, we want to remove any leaves that are touching. I'm just going to pinch that one off a little bit there. Now it's time to put the cage around this one. And then we'll move on to the neighbor here, because it's an interesting development, and we'll show how to plant that. So now some people want to know what they've planted and where they've planted it, and there's a billion different ways of how to mark it, whether you have a journal or you do it on your iPhone. A simple way is taking aluminum pieces of aluminum cans and just engraving the name of what you have planted on the tomato cage. The nice thing about this is no matter how much rain or how much sun you have, the aluminum is indented with the name of the variety, and you can just simply put it on your tomato cage or your string where you've planted it, if you do the Florida weave, and that thing's not coming off, and now you know what type of tomato you have, and by knowing what you planted, you have a good indication of when that plant should reach maturity. So you might want to try the aluminum can method, and if you don't have aluminum cans, you certainly can find somebody who has them. All right, now one of the things you want to keep in mind about how deep to dig your hole is, once you start hitting clay or maybe even rocks, it's as deep as you can potentially go. Because if you're hitting rocks with your trowel, or you've gotten to a soil density that's so thick that you can't dig with your trowel, it's going to be very difficult for that plant to pierce through it and try to grow. And also, it's a very good sign when about every shovelful you dig, you're kicking up worms. So that's a very good indication. By bringing the worms in, it's going to loosen the soil. It's all going to work very well. So we've got this guy here. This is a chocolate cherry. And what has happened is this stalk here is actually a sucker, it appears to be. This is a bottom leaf, and then this one went ahead and developed. So I've got two vertical branches here. Now you could snap that one off and then just focus on this here, but you don't want to do that. Now what I will do is I'm going to snap that off there and then snap this off here. Now I'm going to go ahead and plant this as deep as I can. Why? Well, because, let me get this out of the cup here, I've got a root ball here, and then as I plant it deeper, I'm going to have roots up this stem, and I'm going to have roots up that stem. So essentially, I've got two plants in one. I've got a giant root ball, and then I'm going to have two sets of roots, which is going to make a very strong structure for this plant as it grows and develops in a chocolate cherry that's an indeterminate tomato plant. That means it will grow until it gets too cold and die. So we're going to loosen the bottom roots up here. I've got the hole as deep as I can go. As I talked about, I'm starting to hit a very dense level of soil. So the soil level will be there. So I'm going to pinch the leaves off that there. I'll show you this here. Again, I'm pinching the leaves off here. I'm leaving that very thick stalk for more roots, because this could potentially be a very, very strong, very large tomato plant. So the procedure is the same. Set it down. One hand of rock phosphate to help double the production of the tomato plant. And take a little blood meal. If you're vegan or you don't feel vegetarian, you don't want a blood meal in your garden, there's other options for a nitrogen fix as well. And we're just going to backfill this cherry tomato. There's a little baby radish that got seeded from last year. More worms, you can get in there. It's another worm. All right. Now I'm going to be careful here so I don't damage the fork. Get in here, another giant worm. Put as much loose soil around the stalks that's going to turn into roots as I can. So essentially, it looks like I've got two tomato plants here, when in turn, I really have one that's going to be an extremely strong structure. And this is just by the nature of how this plant grew is why we have that. And that's sometimes the reason why you may not want to remove the suckers, as many gardeners will recommend, because removing the suckers could potentially hurt your plant. Now you see this plant's a little limp here, so I'm just going to take them leaves off to try to keep them off the ground for potential disease. By putting them on the ground, diseases can acquire on them. Now let's see, let me get a cage here. Obviously this is a smaller cage, and we will do what necessary once this plant reaches a very large state if we have to put more structure around it. I'm going to put them in there and then take my label and fold it over, and there you go. It's pretty simple how to plant tomatoes in cages. Now let's go up on the high end where we have prepared a Florida weave. We're going to get our tomatoes planted and then finish the bottom structure on it so the plants have something to grow onto as they grow into the Florida weave. So our Florida weave consists right now of three separate double strings that as the plant grows up, we will be able to allow the plant to grow through them and then have this giant hedge of tomatoes. We have planted our, we've got 7 tomato plants here, a couple of Brandywines, a couple of Rutgers, the beefsteak, etc. So we've got to get a string down at the bottom because it's going to be a little while before they reach this first string here. So we're going to put another string down here. Now we're going to put it about 6 inches to 8 inches off the level of the soil. Reason being, because it won't take much, as you see the second tomato there. That one would already be incorporated into the double weave that we have. So I'm just going to go ahead and start wrapping the string around. And then once I get it constructed, then the tomato plants that are in that area that can be supported by the string, I'll go ahead and put them between. And then we can go ahead and as the other ones grow, we can reach that tip period. If you do a Florida weave with the aluminum can, it works really well, because even for some reason, if all these got pushed together, at least I would be able to string them over top and know exactly what I'm growing. And that's pretty important, so you know how long a tomato plant, the variety you're planting, will take. So let's go ahead and get this strung up. Okay, so I've got it done here. I'm just finishing tying this off. And then obviously these here are a little on the short side, but this top one on this high end here, it's already between, and then as the plant grows, I can go ahead and open it up, and then as I have here, assist the plant in growing. And this is a great way to maximize your space, as well as if you don't want to go purchase a whole bunch of tomato cages or make your own, this is a real easy way to go about doing it. Florida weave with just some strings and some very strong supporting post.
You want to use whole grain cornmeal to prevent early blight with your tomato plants. We have Hodgson Mill cornmeal here that they provided for us. It's non-GMO, it's organic, and you want to use the whole grain cornmeal. You don't want to use the processed stuff, you want to make sure it's whole grain. So what it's going to do, it's going to protect your plant, it's going to protect with a beneficial fungi called Trichoderma. And all you do is you just take a handful of it and you find your tomato plant and you go ahead and you just put it around the base. And you just do that around the base of each plant. And what it does, like I said, it prevents that early blight for your tomato plant. You just take one handful of the whole grain cornmeal, put it on the base of your plant, and then when you want to water, you just go ahead. It doesn't need to stay dry, but it helps prevent that early blight and it is beneficial to your plants. The water, don't have to worry about anything splashing up onto your plants, any sort of bad things in your soil. Thank you for watching. I'm Holly Baird. Join us next time for more organic gardening and home food preservation. This has been the Wisconsin Vegetable Garden. For more information, please visit thewisconsinvegetablegardener.com.